Welcome back to Science IRL, and welcome to our new series with Team Halo, a United Nations initiative that's teaming up science communicators with COVID researchers so they can share their work at the front lines of the pandemic. Okay, I am so pleased to introduce our super special guest. Dr. Shira Weingarten-Gabbay is a postdoctoral fellow in the Sabeti Lab at the Broad Institute of MIT and Harvard. Shira's COVID research focuses on our body's immune response to the virus, and the results of her work could be used to inform the development of new vaccines. Hey, Shira.
Hi, I'm Ollie. Thank you so much for having me. I'm very excited to be here today.
So Shira, before I met you, the aspect of the immune response that I was most familiar with was the antibody response. So antibodies are these Y-shaped proteins that recognize harmful invaders of our bodies like viruses and target them for destruction. But you study a different aspect of our immune system, the T-cell response. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Sure, T cells are a special type of white blood cells in our body. In contrast to antibodies that can see the virus while they're floating outside cells, once the virus enters the cell, it's shielded from antibodies. Antibodies cannot see viruses and cannot get into the cells and neutralize the virus there. Yeah. So the part of the immune system that's responsible for this recognition is T cell. But how can they do it? You can't really see something that is hiding inside the cells. And our body came up with a really beautiful and elegant system that takes viral proteins inside the cell and chop them into small pieces called peptides. And then our cells present these small peptides on the cell surface. So now they're visible to T cell and can signal T cells that will come and destroy the infected cells.
Wow, so they're literally saying like, hey, I'm over here, I'm infected, come get me. And then they kind of sacrifice themselves, right?
Yes, we need to keep in mind that once the virus gets into the cell, it doesn't just hide from the immune system, it doesn't wait there quietly, it actually starts to replicate. It makes more viruses, and then these viruses can get out and infect new cells. So we really want to stop this process, and we want to stop this process as early as possible. And T cell invest a lot of energy, so they constantly go all over our body and survey all the cells and look for this infected cell, looks for this signal for the peptides so they can recognize infected cells. And once they do, they kill the infected cells, stopping this process. And this is one aspect, but another one that is really, really important is that once the T cell recognize infected cells and kill it, it also form a memory cell. What does it mean? It means that the next time that the virus will enter our cells or our body, we already have a pool of cells ready and trained to recognize the virus that can act very quickly on killing the virus. And this memory response, it's what makes second infection, third infection with the same viruses much more easier. And in many cases, we won't even get sick because our immune system will recognize the virus so quickly. And when we design a vaccine, we're basically trying to mimic the same process. We try to teach our immune system how the virus will look like once it's entered the body.
Wow, there's such beautiful and complicated biology going on with the T cell response. From what you were saying, it really sounds like obviously we need to understand this process inside and out for COVID if we want to be able to develop effective treatments and vaccines. So what specifically about COVID T cell immunity does your research focus on?
The T cell recognition depends on specific sequences coming from the virus proteins, these small peptides. If you want to understand better how T cells see these viruses, we want to know which peptides they present to the immune system. So I'm really fascinated by this question. I'm trying to understand better which peptide are presented to the T cells when cells are infected with COVID. And imagine that once we have this information, we can now develop a vaccine that will teach our immune system how the virus will look like once it's entered the cells and which peptide will be presented, so we can already have T cells ready that can recognize this virus in advance.
That's incredible, but how do you even go about answering these questions?
So essentially what we're trying to understand and to do is to take cells and to understand which viral peptides are presented on the cell surface. What we do is we take cells, we grow them in a dish that like that, and then we infect the cells with live virus. We work with a virus that actually caused COVID, and we do it in a special facilities because we need to be extra, extra, extra careful. And after the cells are infected, they will start to do exactly what they're doing inside our body. The virus will start to replicate, you'll form proteins, these proteins will be chopped into these small peptides and presented on the cell surface. So we're interested in these peptides. So we kind of like remove everything else. We take only the peptides, and now we need to understand what peptides are in the small tubes that we have. And now the question is how we know what are these peptides. So we use a technology called mass spectrometry. And this really great technology allows us to take a sample of peptides and put it in the instruments and then to determine what is the sequence of the peptide. So at the end of this process, we know which peptides were presented in cells infected with the virus that caused COVID.
Wait, that's amazing. So who were the peptides?
So we found a lot of peptides coming from familiar proteins in the virus that caused COVID. So for example, we found a lot of peptides coming from the spike that many of us know. This is the really important protein that allows the virus to enter our cells. But the most surprising finding is that we actually found a lot of peptides coming from other proteins, small proteins that were unknown until recently. And these small proteins are hiding inside the viral genomes. They are smaller than the familiar proteins, and we don't even know what is their function. Up to this point, most of the T-cell related COVID research was focusing on these familiar proteins. Our research exposed, if you wish, a new identity of the virus that we didn't know of before. And we think that if we will consider these peptides and we will teach our immune system about this new identity as well, maybe we can have additional important target for the development of vaccine.
That's incredible. And I think it also really highlights the importance of discovery science. Like, of course, the treatment and the vaccine are the end goal here, but it's also really critical that we discover and take the time to probe these big questions so that we can understand the biology of the virus as a whole.
So this is completely right, Molly. And in order to make the best vaccine possible, we want to know as much as we can about the interaction between viruses and the immune system. And our study exposed that these hidden viral proteins can be an important part of this interaction. So this is true for COVID, right? And this is obviously the main interest for everyone now. But this is something that it's also true for other viruses as well. And there are many viruses that cause devastating disease in addition to COVID. This is the focus of our broader research. We can now potentially design hundreds or even thousands of new targets for the design of vaccines.
Incredible. Well, Shira, thank you so much for all of your efforts into this research. I can't imagine getting this project up and running while the rest of the world was shutting down in March, and the amount that you've accomplished in 8 short months is incredible. Thank you to the Sabeti Lab, the Broad Institute, Team Halo, the Vlog Brothers, everyone who made this project possible, and we will see you next time for the next installment of this series. Bye!
Bye!